After Lubko Pass and Brasilov Keep, the CTE updated yesterday, giving us another map of the Russian DLC in the name of the Tsar, called ALBION. And yes, it is the first all-out Battlefield map for Battlefield 1, and it is massive. And it is awesome. So let's see what this map is all about. It is a 7-flag Conquest map overall, and most of the flags are located at the frozen islands and they are surrounded by sea. A nice surprise is that the German spawn is a ship. You can spawn on the ship and snipe some long headshots if you're into that, or you can spawn next to the big ship, where some boats are located to transfer you. Notice here that you can't control the ship. There is also a new landing craft boat that you can stand in the middle of it, or be the gunner of it, if you like, and land in the shore through a cool ramp like a boss. So let's take a look at the flags. The A flag, called Swap Lighthouse, because there's a lighthouse at this objective, and B point, the fishing village, are both on a big frozen island. The A point is the gimme objective for the Germans, but the B flag, the fishing village, is pretty close to the Russian side. So there will be some very interesting moments there. Then we've got the C flag capture point, which is called the Kiss Island. It is a very interesting objective as it stands on its own, in a little island in the middle of the map, and you can access it from all sides. Many flank opportunities there, you have to notice. It is connected to the previous island, the one we were talking before, with a wooden bridge. It is a very exposed flag, but there is some covered rocks and wooden houses there to help you capture or defend it. The next bigger frozen island is where D and E objectives are, the ones that the big coastal batteries are placed. And yes, you can use the guns of these massive batteries. You should know that the guns are destroyed in the beginning of the round, therefore support players should equip the repair tool in order to fix them and be able to use them. These cannons can rotate 360 degrees and they have very big range and some serious explosive damage. These two objectives seem to be the most occupied as well, and due to the fact that the capture area is pretty small, is giving the plane some opportunities to have some massive killstreaks there. Then we've got the F flag, the radio station, which is located at the same big island as D and E are, but much closer to the sea and near the Russian spawn. It's very difficult for Germans to take out F point, cause it's next to the G point, the Russian spawn, and they will spawn there and come to cap it back. There is also a new bomber. It is massive and also very, 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 very slow. It has very good firepower, but it's also a very big target in the sky, so you have to be careful of that. It also has a very cool animation when switching gunner seats in it. I love that. Now there's another surprise. This map has two behemoths. Yes, you heard that good. This map has two behemoths. Each one for each side, you get a different behemoth when needed. For the Germans, it's a dreadnought, and for the Russians, it's an airship. There aren't any land vehicles or nor horses on this map, but really plenty of boats and airplanes, so these are the main transportations for this map. Now, you may call me crazy, but I think this map is going to have the best infantry experience of all previous maps in Battlefield 1. Let me explain why. Due to its map size and the difficulty to move between islands without a boat or a plane, I found players defending flags. Yes, players were actually defending flags, which I haven't really seen in any other previous maps in Battlefield 1. In order to cap an enemy flag, you actually have to act as a squad and do some serious infantry tactics there. This is why this map is going to be one of the best maps in Battlefield 1. Good job, dice there, very, very good job. So that's it for me, guys, for the ALBION map. I can't wait for the map to come out and play it. If you liked the video, please give a thumbs up. If you didn't, a thumbs down. And I'll see you in the next one, guys.